Hi guys, Courtney Skosan here. I'm with my wife Simone, and together with CJ, our little 1.5-month-old boy, we would like to call ourselves the Skosans.
So we get asked the question quite often, how did we meet? And I thought Courtney would go first because we'd like to give both our versions. So how did we meet, Courtney?
Well, I obviously remember it as I was sitting one night busy studying and I got a call from one of my friends. I used to call them my bras. So I got a call from my bra and he said, you know what, if you come to the club before 10 tonight, you know, it's free entrance, all of that. So I was like, you know what, I'm not really interested in going out tonight, but I'll see if I get done with my studies, I'll pull through and I'll see what happens. So I was done at 9 in the evening with my studies. I decided, you know what, let me just jump in the shower, get done, go to the club and chill with the boys for the night. And got there at about maybe 22:10, so I've cut it really short, but I got there. And as I'm standing in the queue, I saw this girl. Yes, and I can't explain it. I saw her and I was like, nah, man, I'm not here for you. I'm here to chill with the bras, so I'm just gonna ignore you. But she looked so beautiful. I remember she had this little gray dress on, and it was a really short dress, but it was a gray dress. And I remember it like it was yesterday, but I flat ignored her. I went to all the guys, greeted them. And then all of a sudden they introduced me to this girl and they're like, ah, this is Simone. I'm like, what? You guys are chilling with this girl? I'm like, okay, why haven't I seen her before? And yeah, I think that's obviously when I introduced myself and said, you know what, I'm Courtney. She introduced herself to say she's Simone. And yeah, that's basically the night we met, or how it actually started out. And you?
Well, it happened by chance that we went to Mainland Square, because those were the days, like the broke days. So going to Mainland, you had to plan it like once a month. So I went there with a few friends. And
it's still not, you're still not rich, so it was just, no, we were more broke that time.
More broke, yeah. So yeah, we went and I see this guy standing in the line just before we planned on leaving. And I said to my friends, Chomis is staying, like, this guy. And then he happened to come to our table. So my friends left me alone. I didn't know how I was gonna get home, but I was like, no, I need to get to know this guy. He was just so, he carried himself so well. Like he had the nicest teeth. Like, I don't know, that's weird, I know. But he wore formal shirt, formal shoes. His jeans weren't hanging below his bum, and I just thought he carried himself really well. Didn't drink, didn't smoke, so proper and decent, which is something I wasn't used to at the time. And I got his name, tried to get his number, not interested. First time I ever wanted a guy's number. So I was like, okay, cool. Eventually, I went home and I got his number from, no, I got his BBM phone.
Yesterday, the old BlackBerry days.
From the friends that we were meeting there. And messaged him. He took like 7 hours to reply to one message. And eventually, he asked me to
go to one of the games, because yeah. I think it was an Australia test against the Springboks, and I obviously wanted to see her again. I was like, I need to see this girl again. We started chatting, all of that kind of stuff, and then she started playing hard to get, and that for me was like, what's going on now? Like, I met you the other night, you didn't seem like a girl that would be like hard to get and all of that. But then she started playing that card and she's like, no, she has to go and sleep early. I'm like, why do you have to sleep early? I mean, it's a Springbok versus Australia game. Like, who doesn't want to go to something like that? She's like, nah, she doesn't really want to go and she has to sleep early. She's got church in the morning. I'm like, oh, okay. Whoa, wait, yeah, here's an opportunity. And she's like, no, I asked her, I'm like, where do you go to church? She's like, no, my father's church. I'm like, okay. Your father's a pastor. She's like, yeah. I'm like, okay, what is the name of the church? Found out the name of the church, everything, wada, wada, wada. I'm like, okay, cool. You know what? I go to CRC, so there's evening service that I usually go to. I don't go to the morning service most of the time. And I would like for you to come with and obviously experience the church and all of that. And obviously that was an opportunity for me to see her again. Because obviously I said, you know what, I need to see her again, talk, and let's see if, you know.
He played the church card though, so I couldn't say no. Like, how do you say no if someone asks you to go to church? you know.
Yes.
So I was like, okay, you know, and yeah. I wasn't too familiar with the area, so Google Maps was my best friend when I met Portnoy, because he would ask me to go everywhere, and I wasn't used to driving anywhere besides to work and back. So.
And she had a car. I was like, yes, she's got a car, she's got her own job, she's, you know, she's looking after herself, she goes to church, pastor's daughter. I'm like, ah, you're ticking all the boxes. So I'm like, I need to get to know you better. Long story short, we went to church, had a good experience at church as well. That time
first of all, we get to church, right? Now, I am used to the old school, small churches, everyone's family, everyone knows each other. And then he takes me to CRC and we go there now. But at the time, it was like a culture shock for me, because it was massive, there were screens, there was lights. And he took me with my handbag still on my shoulder, right to the front of the church, in front of thousands of people for praise and worship. And I was just like...
Now, to check, obviously, you know, she says she's a pastor's daughter, you know, is she really, you know, on the straight and narrow, or is she playing around, you know, we had to check. So obviously went to the front worship, she enjoyed herself in the front. I was jumping up and down, clapping hands and doing all the beautiful stuff. And then obviously after church, we kind of got to talk on the way back. We got to talk a little bit, and that's where I found out a lot more about herself, because she literally like gave me a whole CD in one night. But we had such a good chat that night, and after that night, I think we kind of like said, you know what, we've got so much in common, and we're so different as well in the same breath. So I was so interested in finding out more about her that I said, you know what, maybe, let's see where this goes, maybe we can be friends. Hi, CJ. Okay, so obviously you guys could hear CJ a little bit in the background, so we just got that little situation diffused quickly. Got him here, he was very interested in sitting on the couch. Now, of course, why is mommy and daddy sitting on the couch now, and I'm laying on the floor? So yeah, like I said, obviously went to church. After church, we got to talk a little bit on the way back home to where I left the car, because we only went with the one car. And yeah, we kind of got to chat, and gave me a whole CV. I gave a little bit of my CV, because I was still, you know, a little bit, you know, because at the time I wasn't really looking to be in a relationship, you know. I think it was about the whole year, that year, that I tried to like find myself, you know, with regards to my career, my spiritual life, you know, what I'm doing with my studies and all of that. So I was really serious about what I wanted to achieve, and all of a sudden I met this girl now that, you know, she's interesting, but I also don't want to give too much because I only know her a few days. But obviously there was something, and I just couldn't explain it, and I don't know why I was attracted to her that way. Not just her beauty and the way she looked when I met her, it was like there was something else as well. And that was, for me, was really weird. We got to know each other a little bit better that night, and for me that was special. So, you know, obviously
we arrived back at the house. Right after this deep conversation, we get out of the car and we walk back to our friend's house for a cup of coffee, and all of a sudden Courtnell was someone else. Totally ignored me, as if we never had a conversation, we never went to church together. And I was like, no man, this guy's weird. Like, how one minute you're, you know, having this deep conversation, and then the next minute you think I'm not even a friend's friend or something. So I was like, okay guys, I'm leaving. I have to drive back. So I'll walk to my car, but he was parked behind me, coincidentally.
Yeah, and just to explain the whole thing, you know, like for me, obviously I was back with the boys now. I had to put my hard external up again, you know. I have to be this cool dude again that really doesn't worry much about feelings and all of that kind of stuff, because I was a me, myself, and I guy at the time. So I had to like put that facade up again, that face up again. So yeah, that's just to explain why I ignored her. Well, not ignored, I was kind of just like more cold. Shy, but cold as well, because yeah. I was trying to put up this wall, so I don't get hurt.
Cool. Yeah. And then, so he's like, no, you walk me out, because he parked me in. And we get to the car, I jump in the car, and I'm waiting for him to move his car. So he's like, are you not going to hug me goodbye? And I'm like, really, dude? And I get out of the car, I'm like, yeah, sure. So I leave the ignition on, get out the car, hug him, and then he's like hugging me extra long, and I'm like, okay, you can let go now. And then he looks at me, he's like, can I kiss you? Now, this is the first time this has ever happened to me in my entire life. And it's that awkward moment between the question and me saying yes. So eventually I'm like, what did I say?
I think you just nodded your head.
I was like, okay.
I think you just nodded your head to say yes, and yeah.
And then it was that awkward moment for the time to for our lips to touch, and then we kissed, and it was, it felt right. It really did feel right.
Yeah, I think obviously for me it was, you know what, I saw she was a little bit disappointed in the way I was treating her afterwards, after having that deep conversation and everything. And I obviously didn't want her to leave there thinking, you know what, I'll never make time to see this guy again. So I wanted to make my intentions clear, because I did like her, you know, but I didn't know how much or how far it would go. So I didn't want to take a chance to go too quick, but I said, you know what, maybe one kiss won't be, you know, it won't be too much for her and too much for me as well. So yeah, I guess that was basically why, you know, I think I asked her to kiss me. And for me it was confusing as well, because I was like, yeah, why am I asking her to kiss me and all of that kind of stuff. But I think it was just, we were attracted to each other so much that for me I was like, yo, you know what? I don't want to miss an opportunity to see her again. So for me it was like, okay, it's either you make your intentions clear. I didn't know what type of girl she was, but I thought to myself, you know what, if I don't make my intentions clear to say, you know what, I am interested in you, she might not make time to see me again. So for me that was like kind of like a fear reflex reaction type of thing for me. And well, we're sitting here now 6 years later and we're still together, so it could have been that kiss that kept us together. Who knows whether she would have made time, or I would have even made time to see her again after that. So yeah, that for us was quite special. And that concludes the video for today. That's how we met. And yeah, if you guys want to hear anything else, you know, quite a few suggestions,
questions,
whatever you guys want to ask, throw it below. We'll obviously see how many of your questions we can answer in our next videos. If there's anything else you guys would like to see, please ask, you know. And also obviously subscribe to our channel if you feel like it. You don't have to, you can just come back every week and watch if you want to. We'll try and post and post videos regularly. You know, it's difficult because we also have both our personal channels as well, which we'll also put up in the links. So yeah, that's basically us in a nutshell. We are Simone and Courtney, CJ, and we are the Skosans. So yeah, hopefully we can bring you guys some exciting content for the future. And yeah, this is the video of how we met each other. And like I say in all the videos, I would think that's the theme for our family as well. It doesn't matter how hard life hits you, or how well you're doing in life, don't forget to always look up. God bless you guys. Keep well.
Bye. Say bye.
Say bye, boy. Say bye.